Alright, what's happening everybody? Welcome back to a little more Skyrim. Elder Scrolls 5, I believe. Yes, and Hrgard's adventures. His ongoing ones, anyway. His tales of triumph and valor. Yes, look at Rye rolling her eyes. What is she doing? She's looking at him funny. She's keeping a good eye on her Thane at the corner of her eye. They seem to be off. You know, one seems a little loose there, like she's getting a lazy eye or something, a loopy eye. All right, anyway, what are we going to do this episode? Well, I think you can see I've set up camp, you know, a little, pretty brazen, pretty bold here at the Vinmaker, truly, truly. You know, this is like dancing on a dragon's grave, but as the Dovahkiin, perhaps you're entitled, you know. Perhaps he's entitled. Anyway, it seemed like an ideal spot to set up camp. Let's have a good look. I don't even know why I bothered carrying that second tent for her. She won't use the damn thing. I've tried to get her to go in there, and she stops at the doorway and has no part of it. I changed a couple of things before I pick up, and we head off in, I think it's going to be Solitude's direction. I did change a couple of things. First thing, I can now get my marker. What I decided I was going to, I was so sick and tired of trying to place markers near a location, and it would deny me, the reason it would deny me was because I had fast travel turned off in the Frostfall menu. I've now turned fast travel on. You know, I don't need a toggleable setting to keep me from fast traveling. I'm a big boy, you know, I can handle that on my own, and now I can place markers, my personal marker next to discovered locations. The other thing I did with Frostfall, if I go in and we take a look at it, is I did, I felt like, you know, it's been a long time since I've really been affected, seriously affected by the exposure, you know, and I thought, you know what, I did some testing before I ever started the series. I think I've discussed this a little bit, and I turned the exposure rate down to a more comfortable setting, which was, for me, 0.7. times. It still had the effect of Frostfall, but it wasn't something that was just this major hindrance to travel, you know, along the roads and across the countryside of Skyrim, right? And so, but it's been a while. I don't know if it's the armor I'm wearing that's just offering such a high level of protection. I thought I would turn that up to knock it up one notch, you know, to 0.8, and I did. What did I do? I wanted to turn off the full screen effects. This is basically what this is going to do, is it creates the blurred effect, but I don't like it for the videos, you know. Maybe if I was just playing normally, it would be a nice little addition to let me know, yes, I'm freezing to death, that the old pecker's about to fall off or something, freeze and fall off, yes. But no, I've decided to just shut that down. So, but because there are other cues, there's a little pop up that will come up in the corner of the screen, and we also hear the Dovahkiin suffering ever so slightly from whether it's the frost or the wet or a combination of the two. Anyway, I'm gonna pack up camp here. And what I'm going to do this episode, I think what you're going to see here, if you're looking for action, you're probably not going to see it this time around. I think it's probably going to be a Traveler's episode, and more importantly, most likely a Wheeler Dealer's episode. As I've got, what I would like to do is get to Solitude, maybe conduct a little bit of business under the radar, you know, because that's clearly important at this point. Under the radar, and conduct a little bit of business there. Grab a few supplies for my ongoing build back at Lakeview Manor, because that's where I'm eventually going to get to. I'm going to catch a cart here, save us a little bit of a trouble. I like the idea of the carts, you know. You know, whereas I'm really against just that automatic fast travel between two locations. I do like the idea of hiring a, you know, a carriage, a cart driver to cart us around. Yes, a carriage driver. To cart us around from point A to point B. That's quite nice. And it's nothing new here. Now, I'm hearing a little Nurnroot action. Give me your wings, foul butterfly. Yes. Oh. The screams, the high-pitched squeals that they unleash. I know y'all can't hear it, but it's horrifying. Really, it is. Truly. Truly. Oh, look at them all. Good lord. They know the Vinmaker is in the area. Yes. Looking to steal their precious wings. Their golden wings of life. Of life-giving nectar. Alright. Now then. Oh, we've got ourselves a mud crab. Well, I'm gonna have to, deal with him. There we go. And well, you know what? That one tick. Oh damn, this water is anything but. Oh, we're soaking goddamn wet. With that one tick added to Frostfall, that could have been a foolish choice, but at least I'm really close to solitude here. So it shouldn't be any sort of major. Solitude sawmill? Oh, really? That's fantastic. Should perhaps inquire a bit. Look at Raya. What's she doing? Doing a little fishing or something. She saw a fish she did not like. Yes. Thought perhaps it was a threat to her thane, and she's off dealing with it. Good. You two seem to be up to no good. Jorin.
Here for work? Get an axe, and bring me all the wood you can chop.
Here for business, in fact.
Come in. I was just about to take a break.
Well, it's not break time, it's business time, sir. Perhaps they won't supply... You know, it could be that that the lumber mills, they won't supply Lakeview Manor because it's so far away. You know, these lumber mills may supply one of the other buildable estates through Hearthfire. So I think I'll just leave it be. I'm not going to press the issue. The man had very little to say to me. Now, it could have been that the orcs actually running the show around here. I'm not really sure. Anyway, stay focused. We'll head for Solitude. You can hear the Vindmaker just dripping wet right now. Good lord. And we're at, 94% and 51% exposure. You know, it could be good that I crank up Frostfall a little further. I'm gonna test it, you know. Test it out and see how it's playing, especially in some of the colder climates. Alright. The busy port of Solitude. Oh, there's some serious... Oh, no. I thought those were fireballs way down there. it's just eagles. Alright, I guess what I think I'm going to do is I will head right into Solitude. The wheelin dealer is preparing. Oh. Preparing to strike a deal. Find a bargain, yes. He's preparing to wheelin deal, in fact. And so it'll be a stop here in Solitude. I'll probably catch the cart going to heading for Whiterun. Do a little more business there. Are the caravans in town? Well, isn't that just something? Isn't that something else? What I want to do here is I might as well take full advantage. Now, where's the better prices? Don't I have a better prices? Amulet. I guess I don't. It's 15 to speechcraft. That could be quite. I don't know if that would be better than my necklace of minor haggling. Prices are 12% better, but would the boost to speechcraft outweigh that? Y'all let me know what you think in a comment if you know better. If you've got the a better sense of that than I do. I think for the time being I will just stick with my necklace of minor haggling. And where's Rasak?
Welcome in the cities.
Oh.
So we make our camps outside the walls.
Razinda. Where's my what's her name? I can't remember. Kaelin or something like that.
Tools,
where's Raya?
Wares and weapons. All for
sale. Oh, they're different. I didn't realize that they were. I thought it was one caravan, one Khajiit caravan. But they appear to be different. Different merchants.
I welcome you, friend. How may I serve you?
All right. Oh, here we go. Do you work? You work for Rasad? Where's Rasad at?
He hired the others and paid for my goods. I am allowed to run the caravan, but I pay Rasad a percentage of my profits. I say this without bitterness, for it was Rasad who saved me from a life of servitude aboard a trading ship. I am grateful to have the life that I do now. It is a far cry from my days as an orphan on the streets of Corinth.
Sir, I didn't ask for the life story, but I appreciate it. Yes. Appreciate it. All right, let's see your wares. Foul cat.
Take a look.
Rogar gets some sort of insult in. Just before doing business. It's to help him gain advantage in his wheeling dealing ways. Very complex. Very intricate methods at play here, people. I don't blame you if you can't fully comprehend. But there is method to his madness. Clearly. All right. Anyway, let's see. First thing I need is lantern oil. We'll take a big shot at that. Seven doses, seven vials of the good stuff. It's not really the good stuff, but it does light his way, yes. I will grab this potion of health 3. And, alright, let's get down to business. Now, dang it. You know, if I could potentially lighten my load, I may do I may be tempted to do a bit of a dungeon dive somewhere. Heals the target for 51 points, but not undead. Atronox or machines. You know, this could be something good to give to Saran and just roll alongside her and let her heal the Talos out of me, yes. The Batalos. Alright, I think I'll... Is this mine? Where did I get the Staff of Mending in the first place? I don't even know. That's not bad, though. Still, I think it needs to be sold. Oh, here we go. The Orisimar. A chieftain longbow. Yeah, so be holding on to that sucker for the time being. Alright, let's get everything organized. How's he looking for arrows? Does he have anything? Nothing. Amazingly. Alright, the ebony longbow. Now, the Orisimar chieftain longbow, it's a longbow. I think I was, you know, just on the fly. I'd been comparing it to my short bows. It's 101, you know, whereas my ebony is 112. So, and my glass is 109, so it's I would be taking a bit of a hit, but good lord if that bow isn't something to look at. Yes. Alright, what can I part with here? I guess I'll start just getting rid of some... You know, I gotta get rid of all this stuff. That can go. Maybe I should hold on to the Amulet of Stendar for Raya when I finally do get her a shield. And I'll hold on to the Amulet of Dibella, and hopefully somebody will be good enough to leave me a comment and let me know what they think about if that speechcraft, that 15 points to speechcraft, will be better than will offer me better prices than my Necklace of Minor Haggling at 12%, a 12% increase there. Increased speed. Do I want this? Get rid of that. Now I've got this ebony armor I'm lugging around. Am I gonna find a use for it? I really don't know. And the boots of the old gods sneaking 30% better. That's pretty solid. Oh, I don't know what to get rid of here. There's plenty that could go. Just looking to get rid of things that I know I'm not going to use at this point. Maybe we'll head down here, get rid of some pelts. That can go, and I think that's probably going to do it. I don't think he's got anything else I'd be interested in. No, he certainly doesn't. Actually, maybe some moon sugar. I don't know what it's good for, though. I mean, I could look it up online, but I like not knowing, you know, until I actually tested it. That's part of being the alchemist, right? So I'm going to leave it, so don't be leaving it in the comments informing me, please.
May your road lead you to warm sands.
Yes, yes, sir. And the only way I'm going to figure out what the moon sugar is good for is to buy a batch.
Elsewhere is far away from here.
Is to buy a batch and start, you know, fixing stuff. Mm-hmm. You know, well, making a few potions with it, seeing what potential effects lie dormant in the ingredient. All right, should I bother going in here? I'm really doing a lot of hemming and hawing with as far as some of the items I'm carrying, lugging around. I don't know if I want to get right in here behind enemy lines. Maybe I should limit my business to Whiterun. You know, because I've got three potential locations. I could limit my business to Whiterun. You know, I took advantage of the caravans. I think that's probably good enough. I think Rorgard trying to decide whether it's wise to enter solitude at this state in the Civil War. You know, clearly he's been identified as the Dovahkiin, as the ice veined Bonebreaker of the Stormcloak Legion. Yes. All right, sir, I'd like to hire your cart, my good man. Do you make runs to Whiterun from here?
Need a ride?
Oh, I do. Is that... I take that as a yes. Yes.
Where do you want to go?
Sir, clean the shit out your ears, clearly. I just said that.
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
Excellent, sir. Excellent. Raya, my dear.
Get up there.
Hopefully she gets in. Hopefully we don't leave her abandoned here. Come on, sir. Get rolling, crack the whip, or do whatever you need to do. Get that horse in motion. Okay. Hungry and thirsty, eh? Oh, look at this. Hova kid. Well, fancy meeting you here. What have you been up to? He's been here, he's been here scoping out the ladies at the local stables, yes. you drunkard. He's been, it's been a non-stop party since we left him back at Lakeview Manor. That's ridiculous that he showed up there. That's funny. Clearly it had something to do with the fast travel. That's fun. Look at this.
Discount on both sides. The winners will persecute us for helping the losers.
I had not thought of it that way.
What do you think here? Are they just getting ready to set up camp? You know? Put their wares on display? It's possible. Which is some seriously good fortune when you think about it. We hit two caravans in the matter of one day. Alright. Well, it's a shame that I'm arriving in town as late as I am, you know. I may have to rent a room here now if I want to take advantage of the merchants here. What I think I'll do is pitch a camp here somewhere rather than rent a room out in the fields, and I'll rest them. We'll take a little break here, and, you know, I'll see you all in the morning. We'll get down to a little more business. A little more wheeling and dealing. Alright, morning all. Well, it's closer to noon than anything, but, yes, officially it is still the morning. You can see, if you're looking really closely, you'll see that Hergard has a branch on his hip here. When I was off getting wood for the fire, just over yonder, I realized, you know, when I go into this menu, I do have the option to craft some different items, you know, stuff like a longbow, the walking stick, which increases my movement speed by 10% when held, has to be unsheathed, traveling on foot. And there's different stuff like fur armor that can be crafted on the fly. I could even erect what appears to be a tanning rack here if I was so inclined, which is great for the hunter. You know, I wish I'd realized this a little bit sooner. I could have played it, quite a bit differently, at least early on, but he's not so much the strict hunter woodsman anymore, as you know. He's been drawn into war as he wanted, but he came here to fight the good fight, and that's clearly what's happened, and it has transformed him, although he still does depend on those old skills as the hunter woodsman. He's very much a warrior these days, yes. Very much. Alright, let's pack things up. I thought to myself, why even bother putting a tent down for her? She's not going to sleep anyway.
I await your orders, Thane.
You must be exhausted, my dear. Follow me.
My blade is yours to command, Thane.
We're nearly home, yes. We've been on the road now for days. It's been quite the adventure Rye and I have had here. It all started when we left Lakeview Manor, oh, so many episodes ago. What I think I'd like to do is get my, you know, get enough buffs to speed going where travel when I'm just walking is a little bit more acceptable, because this is a little slow. It's a little sluggish, but sometimes...
Karjit is just a guard and has nowhere else to sell.
Amazingly, they didn't even bother setting up camp here, but it looks like Rasad is willing to sell.
You
maybe it's because I was I had crafted my pitched my camp so close to
warm sands, friend.
Yeah, this is a little odd. I find it weird that they haven't set up camp yet. Maybe I should head into the city first. Then we'll stop by and we'll see Rasad. But basically, I mean, sometimes this feels like I'm just running, hustling a little bit too quickly. You know, well, it doesn't feel too bad right now. This is just far too slow. I think it's better when I'm in the first person. You know, that way you don't see him running around like a fool all bent over. You know? Just, what the hell? What was he doing? This is ridiculous. Wild deer combusting through the doors of Whiterun. That's pretty funny. And we've got the whole... clearly, the Hover Kid had something to do with this. Wouldn't you say, Raya?
I'm still here.
Good. The deer didn't scare you off.
Lead on, my
Tell thing. Me, what do you say about the deer having something to do with the Hover Kid's presence here in Whiterun?
Let's get going.
Oh, God damn it.
Lead on.
Damn you, woman! Rurgard, not going to spare the rod with her, no. Not that I got this great beaten stick. Oh, she's going to be getting clubbins left, right, and center out there. Terrible. Makes me feel like a slave driver or something. It's just awful. Damn it, Rurgard. Damn you, Raya, for forcing my hand as you did. Oh. All right. look at my club is all bloodied here. Alright. Well, I don't really want to do business at War Maidens, if I'm being perfectly honest. Actually, I'm surprised that she's... Well, you know, when you think about it, after... What was the Jarl's name here? Balgruf. Yes, it's been so long. Once he got to overthrowing... And we put our own man in place. I'm surprised that nothing happened with War Maidens and Ariana over there. I think that's her name. Because her father was steward to Balgruf.
No offense, but you're not looking so good.
Really? Perhaps I've contracted something. The rattles. Let's see here. Oh, I'm dying. Thank you, good sir. Your warning. Raya, what am I paying you for exactly? You know, clearly you could have mentioned something. Like I'm growing fangs or have a thirst for blood. You know, my skin has turned pasty white. Something would have been nice, a little heads up. Clearly I'm not carrying a mirror with me. Damn it. Alright, so I've been struck with the first phase of full-blown vampirism. Well met there, Battleborn. Actually, not really, no. I don't like you and your family. Alright, where am I gonna go? Oh, we got Bellathor here. Alright, well, let me guzzle... slam back the cure disease here. There we go. Maybe I should have embraced the vampire. The vampirism. I don't know. Anyway, let's head in here. What do you think Bellathor will have to say about me, you know... Coming in here, clubbing
around. I'm sure you'll find what you're looking for. If not, let me know. I might have it stored away.
All right, we'll put that away for the time being. Bellathor, my good man, are you ready for a new round of wheeling and dealing?
Imperials, Stormcloaks, I don't care who's in charge around here. I just want to make money.
Good, Bellathor. I have to admit, I found a little skoom out there. On the download, just for you,
everything's for sale, my
just
friend.
Just for you.
Everything.
Well,
if
show me
sister,
your wares.
I'd sell her in a second.
Well... Oh, you don't have a sister.
Trinkets, odds and ends.
I was gonna say, I probably have enough coin to buy her. Yes, at least for one night. At least for one night, Bellathor. Alright, let's see. Now, what should I part with? I guess it's time to start going down. Actually, you know what? Let's start and see what he has for arrows. Alright, he's got some orcish. He's got quite a few dwarven. I'll take the Justicars. Alright, he only had 750, so he's clearly been, you know... He's lost his edge, lost his touch. It must be the skooma I'm feeding him. There's something lost. The man has lost his master status as master merchant. Just no more. Perhaps he suffered a big blow to his ego, losing such in our last exchange. Yes, he couldn't believe that he got taken. He got fleeced so severely by this lowly hunter woodsman. Known as the Vinmaker. Alright, what else do you have, Bellathor? I could probably use a little more lantern oil. So I'll buy all that up. Alright, he's sitting at 1,343. This is gonna go quick, Bellathor. This is gonna go quick, sir. I'm glad you feel like your purse is heavy once more, but it's gonna all be coming back my way. Yes. All right, let's just, I guess... Now, am I going to need these pelts for anything? Back at Lakeview Manor. You know, it's possible. Wolves are common enough. I know that that Rye is carrying some pelts for me as well. So I'll have a look once I get back there. Should I just go down the list and sell all the jewels I've got? I could get rid of some of these poisons. I've got some stuff in here, like... I don't know, the weakness to shock, weakness to magic... This stuff can go, but this could probably would be better sold at the alchemy shop next door, you know. So I may hold on to those. What else? What else? I don't know what I want to part with. I mean, I could get rid of the ebony armor. It's not something that the Vindmaker will wear. It could be something that I put Riot in, though, once I get a full set together. No, you know what, I think, well, hold on a second. The Mask of Otar is heavy. Maybe I'll hold on to the Ebony for the time being. Well, and I'll have a good look at it back at Lakeview Manor. I mean, it all comes down to that. I don't know why I thought doing the wheeling and dealing beforehand was a smart choice. It should have been something I do after I have a good look at all the items that are potential keepers, you know? I don't know. All right, this can go. And... I guess it's going to come down to me just getting rid of some of my jewels here. Petty Soul Gem, Common Soul Gem, those can both go. The Sapphire, the Ruby. The Emerald, I've got, well, look at this, I've got 8 Amethysts here. And I guess the Emerald, you know, and, you know, something cheap that can, I can throw his way here. Oh, the Skooma! I forgot all about it. I've got 4 of the suckers. What do you have for sale, Belthor? Let's see. No, 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 sir. I know, I know. You see, what happened there was Rogard flashed him the 4 vials of Skooma. Even the bloodstained ones and his pupils, or Belthor's pupils, dilated. Yes. he's now itching for the Skooma. So we'll see what he's got here. Just to appease the man. You know, just to feed his addiction. Keep the man down, yes, so we can we can take advantage of his of his weakened mental state, yes. There's nothing that I really want that he's got, though. That's the problem. I mean, I could grab the dwarven arrows, but I'll grab that. Grab that. That's not a bad exchange when you think about it. Let's see. Alright, let's see. How many can I part with? Actually, I can get rid of all of them, so that's good. Alright, there you go, Belthor. Don't say I never did anything nice for you. Clearly, you're getting that, getting that at wholesale or something, yes. Alright, Belthor. Pleasure, sir.
Do
a pleasure.
Come back.
I will, sir. Clearly, he's asking me back. Not because he manages to fleece me anymore, but because I am
one
the schooner.
Of your relatives if you're looking
yes.
to sell.
Yeah,
that's a little joke.
He's losing it. He's lost it, in fact. Yes, it was lost long ago. Our last encounter, when we last crossed paths. Alright, let me kill my lantern. Good lord, it's bright out today, isn't it? Well, I think I'm just going to have to... Oh, you know what I forgot to go looking for? Stuff like glass,
you know. What's wrong with Skyrim these days? Everyone is obsessed.
Belthor would have had a few items like that, I'm sure.
I hope you're finding the city in proper order, Thane.
Yes, yes, I am. It's good. Good, my dear. I'm sure Belthor would have had some glass. What else is it? What are the other items I need?
Staying safe, for
the build? I can't even remember now at this point. I know I need the lumber, but I've got a good supply of lumber sitting back at camp. Or back at the build site. I need glass. I mean, I need ingots and stuff like that.
Yes.
Why does everybody think that I want to talk to them when I walk by? I don't get it. All right, let's head right out of town here, Vindmaker. I guess the stop in Whiterun really wasn't all that eventful. Didn't serve a great purpose. I got rid of some of my shiny trinkets, but that's about it. You know, came in more or less just to I knew that Belthor was probably hurting for the Skooma. You know, he tries to keep it on the down low. The Vinmaker, you know, he plays the part of Skooma dealer for the man, yes. And he knows how to keep things quiet and hush hush. You have to know how to do such things when you're the Dovahkiin. Okay, the caravans have finally set up a proper camp. That's good. Ryak, follow, my dear. Come now. We've no time to waste. I'm sure we're getting short on episode time here. All right. We'll go have words with the crazy cats down here. Rasad, my good man. My good man, beast. Yes.
Surrender, be merciful.
All right. What
ill fortune. Warm sands, friend. How may this one serve you?
I'd like to see your wares, my good man, Rasad.
Take a look.
All right. I guess hit up the what you got for weaponry first. Nothing much. Nothing much at all. Alright, here we go. Alright. Now, let's see. I'm trying to remember what it is I'm actually looking for. So I'm looking for glass if I can find it. Not seeing anything. Amazingly, I can't remember anything else. Oh, charcoal would be good, but I can make that easily enough back at camp. I'm not going to worry about that. No, I guess he doesn't really have much of anything that I want. Just get rid of some of these jewels, I guess. Although these could be useful for building something, some sort of furnishing. Some sort of ornate decoration for the manor, but it's too late now, isn't it? Yes, it is. I'll get rid of some of these tomes I'm carrying around here. Soothe. Oh, incinerate. Actually, look at that. Those are priced quite nicely. All right, I'll leave them alone. Let's get rid of. Actually, the wolf. Call it in a wolf. As the Hunter Woodsman wouldn't be too bad at all. For that one-time affair. Oh, I forgot I've got this dragon scale helmet of peerless illusion. Maybe I'll see if I can pawn that off at the Riverwood Trader. What else do we have here? I don't know what to get rid of. The Ring of Minor Sneaking, am I going to get a use out of it? Am I going to have to go full stealth mode in the future? I don't know. But again, he's only got the 57 gold, so I don't know what I'm considering here, really. You know? Let's just move on. Pleasure, Rasad, as always.
May your road lead you to warm sands.
I can't. We've fought alongside one another. Yes. These Khajiit, Vinmaker. Back at Markarth. It's probably happened other times as well, and I'm simply not remembering. All right, Hovakir. You ready to ride here, Raya? Clearly, yes, you do. You are ready. She clearly needs it. Good lord, where do you keep that horn, my dear? She just pulled that out of nowhere. Quite odd. Quite filthy, in fact, yes. All right, let's roll. Ride for... he's... the Windmaker still carrying around his whooping stick here. Alright, let's get the bow in hand and make a ride for Riverwood. I would imagine I'm probably running long at this point. But you know what, who cares? Run a little long, get as much wheeling and dealing done as I possibly can in this episode. And next episode, when I finally do roll when I roll into the manor, you know, when I get back home, it'll be a builder's episode, you know. So we're scaling back the action slightly, the exploration, taking care of some pressing matters, and I'll probably, you know, do my my brew that I've been speaking of. I'll do that between episodes at some point, and have a good look at everything I'm carrying, you know, see what works. I really don't think I can let this fly. I think I'm gonna have to come off and deal with these shockers. It's just in my nature as the Dovahkiin. What am I gonna give the man, though? That's the question. That is the question. Free, and should I share some items with him or no? I don't know if I have anything to give him. I'm just gonna free him. Hopefully Ryze's taking care of business back there. Alright, he's done. There we go. I've got the upper hand here. I hear Raya hacking and slashing back there. Did we save the Nord? We did. Wonderful, my dear. You came through when I needed you most. Oh, she's definitely in some sort of angered blood rage. Yes, you can tell when she goes all squinty-eyed like that. You know, she's got death on her mind. All right, the legged longbow. Might as well grab it. I'm sure I can sell it. Fetching a decent enough price. I'll search my two kills. We'll leave the man that Raya and the unknown Nord put down. We'll leave him alone. He wasn't really my kill. I don't feel like going back for him at this point. The horses stayed quite calm. In fact, quite surprised. Hope again, you know, maybe the break did him some good, you know. He's quite cowardly, this horse. Maybe I should jack up his aggression level. Remove the kind of the coward rating that I've given him. And let him get into the melee, into the fray. I'd have to give him a boost of health if I were to pull something like that off, you know. Otherwise, I feel like I would lose him quite quickly out there. Damn. The wolves were just having a small meal. Rogard, you don't need to kill everything you see, sir. Just move along. Oh, they had an ambush set up and everything. Well, we can't be luring them right into Riverwood. That would be very undovakin of you, sir. Yes. All right. I guess they've given up the chase, but I would imagine that my faithful steward is back there. Skinning them as we speak, you know. Alright, so we'll roll in here to the Riverwood Trader. Do a little business with my man. I can't remember his name. I cannot remember either of their names. Camilla and her brother. I don't know. Truly, I only remember Camilla. She's left such an impression on the dead man. After that night of passionate, never mind. Y'all never saw that, but it did happen, and I don't feel like discussing it, no. Alright, let's park the horse here. Vidmaker.
You think I'm afraid of you?
What's happening here? What is Riot doing? Picking a fight with somebody out here. Oh, the wolf. Oh no, that's Stump. What's Riot doing then? I think she's muscling this guard around, this white run guard. He clearly made a pass at her, grabbed a breast or something. Very brazen, sir. I'm surprised you're still standing. I'm surprised she didn't cut you down. I wouldn't make that mistake again, my friend. No. Anyway. Alright, so we've got Camilla and who's the other man? I can't remember.
It Camilla. Means so much to us to have the claw back where it belongs. Thank you.
Oh, Camilla. Alright. Oh, Lucan. That's right. Lucan. Yes, Lucan.
Thank you so much for taking care of those thieves.
Not a problem, sir.
Riverwood Trader is back to the way it used to be.
Raya's quite, she's looking at me like, don't you?
You and me.
Damn you, you scandalous man, you. Yes, I thought you only had eyes for me.
The Riverwood Trader is everything you need in a general store.
Okay, let's see here. What do you got for sale, Luke and my good man?
Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that.
And straight down to the end, and let's see. So I'm looking for glass. Here we go. 10 of the suckers. I'm over capacity now. That may have been foolish. What else am I looking for now? Goat horns, that's right. Need some goat horns. We'll take them. And there's one more straw. There it is, right there. I kept thinking wool for some reason, you know? That's what when I couldn't think of anything beyond glass, I kept thinking wool. It must be wool. No, it's straw. I knew it was something. Something kind of like that. Alright, well, this is going to put me way over capacity. I'm going to have to sell something. That's really what it comes down to. He's got some Anzaleels here for sale as well. I'll pick them up. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'll grab all the straw I can carry. I don't want to get rid of the, you know, the one thing that I'm thinking about is getting rid of the ebony armor. Now, what I could do is I could pass some things Raya's way, and, I've got the legged longbow that needs to go as well.
I'm still here.
Alright, so let's make a quick exchange here, my dear.
Of course, Thane. How can I be of service?
Alright. I'll give her the glass. Oh, I need to take things from her first. Clearly. Okay, I've got... deer hides and fox pelts, cow pelts, the goat hide. Oh, I could potentially use the goat hide. I think I need it to mount an evil goat head. I've got 10 wolf pelts as well. Ridiculous. Grand and greater soul gems. There's lots of stuff happening here. All right, I think I'll leave the, we'll give her the goat hide back. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna walk into Falkreath. I'm gonna slay Jarldengir of Stones, prize-winning goat, and I'm gonna use that pelt to mount on my wall, in fact, yes. Yes, I forgot, I said I was gonna do it, and I will do it, yes. Even if it costs me a night in jail. And several lashes at the hand of the Sun Killer, yes. Who's the Stormcloak General represented in the area. Okay, what else? Oh, I wanna get rid of the straw and stuff like that. Lost track really quickly there, didn't I? Oh, wow. What's she got for weapons that perhaps she does not need? Oh, that's my stuff. Good lord. Pull your head out your arse here, Binmaker. She doesn't really... Oh, she's got a bunch of meat here. You know what I could do? I could sell the venison to Bellathor as well. Not Bellathor, Lucan. Alright. Get over here. I'll give her the straw. She's gonna love these goat horns. Methinks. And where's the straw? Where's the straw at? There we go. It's all for now, my dear. Oh!
My thing.
She was stuck with her...
My sister Camilla or I will be happy to help you.
Well, I really would prefer to, do a little business with your sister.
Maybe you're looking for something particular.
You're right about that, sir. We've been through this before. We both know what I'm referring to.
We
yes.
carry just about anything you could need. I know some of it looks like junk, but everything's a treasure in the right light.
True, true.
Oh, a bit of this and a bit of that.
All right, Lucan. You know, that's the first time I ever heard him say that. But the treasure, everything's a treasure when it's sitting in the right light. Okay. Let's get down to business one more time here. Let's get rid of the cowhide can go. The deer hides, the fox pelt. I need to shed about 30 pounds here, people. What else did I grab off of Ryo? Okay, now I do have the legged longbow. That can go. 17 pounds. Nice. 10 more pounds. Need freeing. Oh, I've got the meat. The venison. Oh, what did I sell? Did I sell my cheese wheel? Unbelievable. Lucan! Where is it now? I did. He's got five... He had four wheels already. Are you kidding me? selling it back to me for a huge markup. Lucan, I thought we were friends, sir. Clearly, he doesn't like the way I look at his sister. No. Alright, there we go. I think that drops me. Yeah, that's a big plus. Okay. And he's still got 596 gold here. Here we go. This is perfect. The Dragon Scale Helmet of Peerless Illusion. I don't think I'll be using that anytime soon. That's just a seller. Oh, and the Helm of the Old Gods. At 207. Is there anything else that I can buy from him? You know what? I might as well stock up on the Lantern Oil. Oh, that's my stuff. I've got 17 of the suckers. Well, clearly I have already stocked up on the stuff, haven't I? Is there anything else? What have you, Lucan? What have you? Not seeing much. A couple of healths. I don't think it's gonna give him enough money that I can actually pawn off that, what I want to get rid of, which is that Helm of the Old Gods. Could buy my cheese wheel back. Oh, you know what? Oh, no. Ah, screw it. We'll leave him with what he's got. Pleasure, Lucan. Camilla? She wanted to make sure she was positioned at the door so that we could, she could give me
a fine annoying look.
Annoying look as I walk on by. She just wanted to brush up next to the man. To catch a good whiff of his manly mustache-y musk, yes. All right, Raya, we ready to roll on out. Camilla, I still expect you at Lakeview Manor someday, my dear. What
You're
say you?
You're a strapping young man.
Oh, thank you.
Don't be a stranger.
Oh, I won't. Huh? All right, anyway, off we go, and I definitely need to wrap it. Oh, wow, have we ever run long here? Obscenely long. I'll have to make some edits. Scale back the amount of content, wheeling and dealing content that was done here this episode. Appreciate y'all stopping by. I hope you had a good time. What is wrong with the Vinmaker? Good lord, he's angry. He's angry that Camilla did not depart with him. Perhaps he's angry at Raya. He had to club her a couple of times. All right. What's he doing? He's not pleased at all. No. Okay, y'all. I hope you had a good time. At least some of you. I hope you enjoyed some of this wheeling and dealing episode. Not always the greatest of stuff, but it certainly has its place here in this series. I hope you'll tune in next time. We'll be rolling into we'll be heading home back towards Lakeview Manor, and the build will resume back there. So, until then, of course, remember why it hurts. Later.